This is Cruise News Today with Doug Parker.
Good morning. Here's your cruise news for Sunday, April 2nd. Happy birthday, Mom. Norwegian Pearl has arrived in Boston to begin its 2023 summer program in the Northeast after spending the winter months sailing the Caribbean. Through October and from Boston, Pearl will offer different itineraries to Bermuda, Canada, and New England. After completing its Northeast run this year, the Pearl will head back down to South Florida for its winter season, sailing from Port Miami. And Royal Caribbean's Symphony of the Seas is in its first ever dry dock after being in service for 5 years. Photos posted by Royal Caribbean's chief meteorologist James Van Fleet show the dry dock underway, where the ship is getting general maintenance and minor upgrades. Following the dry dock, Symphony will officially kick off its summer season in the Mediterranean on April 16th. Cruise ships are required to undergo a dry dock every 5 years, regardless of upgrades. And starting yesterday, multiple cruise lines implemented changes to their procedures and policies. Norwegian Cruise Line started returning to its e-muster safety drills, while Carnival Cruise Line increased its daily gratuities by $150 per person per day. Grand Turk dropped its vaccination requirements on the 1st, allowing everyone to now go ashore, while Carnival's Behind the Fun Tour officially returned fleetwide yesterday. Additionally, Royal Caribbean and Celebrity Cruises now require extra credit card verification to prevent fraud, and luxury cruise line Ponant also dropped its vaccination requirement. And cruise line stocks were mixed on Friday. Carnival Corporation flat 10.15, Royal Caribbean up 1%, 65.30, and Norwegian up 1.5%, 13.45. Breaking news and industry coverage at cruiseradio.net. I'm Doug Parker with Cruise News Today.
Cruise News Today is a production of Cruise Radio. Behind-the-scenes content and extras are now available at patreon.com/cruiseradio.